Hi, and welcome back to the channel. Today, what I would like to talk with you about is my personal approach to investing in residential property. Specifically, I'm going to talk about one rule from Warren Buffett that everyone should follow. Two, making sure that you put together kind of the right formula. And three, what your team needs to look like to be successful. So the first one of those is a rule that I definitely follow by Warren Buffett, and that is, rule number one is to never lose money. Rule number two is to never forget rule number one. When it comes to investing, whether it's real estate or it's low-cost index funds, the real aim of your investment is to ensure that you never lose money, to make sure that you're kind of a temperate investor, someone who is doing your research, someone who is not just kind of following what the trends are, but that you're looking for solid investments, that you're doing your homework and ensuring that where you're putting your money is either going to come back to you as a return or zero loss. So make sure that you're doing that work. Make sure that you're always putting yourself in a position that your investment is going to pay off. The moment you start losing money is the moment you really start setting yourself back, having to regain those funds that you lost, and then starting that investment process all over again. So make sure you're doing your homework, and as Warren Buffett says, just never lose money in whatever your investment may be. The second piece is making sure that you have a formula that works for you. Now, me specifically, when I'm looking at investing in residential properties, what I want to do is make sure that I find a property that I can buy, and say I spend $200,000 on that property. What I like to do is ensure that I don't put more than 30% into the property so that I can get it ready for the market. So in this case, I would not want to exceed more than $60,000 in updates or upgrades to get this property back on the market. Now, with that being said, in this scenario, what I would look to do is find a property where I could walk away making anywhere between $50,000 to $80,000 on that property. So those numbers seem fairly subjective in terms of what it is I'm trying to buy, the investments that I'm looking for, but that's really what my formula is. Until I find a property that I feel fits that or gets me close to that, it's really hard for me to waver outside of that. They're out there. It takes a lot of research. It takes a lot of homework, but you can find them. And what I also like to do is make sure that my formula fits within a three-month window. So I want to be able to find that house, close that house, get the team back together that's going to renovate it or upgrade it, and then get that property back on the market in less than 3 months. Now, being able to do that allows me a couple things: to be able to quickly adjust to the market, but also understand what the market is doing so that my next investment puts me in a better position to, you know, meet the needs that I have or to sell the property quickly. So make sure that you have a formula that works. Mine may be way off for you. You may be trying to shoot for a lot less into the properties. You may be trying to make a lot more out of properties. But for me, it's kind of a numbers game. I want to be able to get in, do a couple properties throughout the year, and pull out, make that investment that I know I can make. So make a formula and stick to that formula, and don't waver from that formula throughout your process. The third piece to this is making sure that you have the right team. And when I say team, I want you to think about this as an entire process. I want you to think about your agent, your lawyer, your banker, the inspector that you use, the individual trades who are going to be coming in and out of a house for you, and maybe even those people who really are on your team that are helping you search for properties, inspect the properties, maybe actually do the work on the properties. But your team has to be kind of a well-oiled machine, if you will. They need to know what your expectations are, how they fit into that process, what the timeline looks for this investment, and they all need to know their part so that they can play that part and be integral to the success of you selling the property. So make sure that your team is the right team. Find them. Sometimes you have to switch them in, sometimes you have to switch them out. They are a role player in your team, so make sure that you find the individuals who play the right role for you. Again, when I look at my overall kind of strategy for investing in residential properties. One, it is never lose money. Two, it is making sure that I have a formula that works. And three, making sure that my team is dedicated to what I'm doing, they're informed of what I'm doing, and they're playing their role in the process for this. I hope today's video shines some light on the way that I look at residential properties when I'm investing. I hope that it's helpful for you, something that you can take away and maybe implement into your own game. And as always, if there's any questions or comments, leave them below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks again.